Welcome back to For Fantasy's Sake, Episode 9. We're in for a good week of fantasy football.
Yep, it's the midseason mark in the NFL season, so we're going to be able to go over a couple of things just so you guys can see them. And yeah, let's get right into it. We are at the midseason mark of the NFL season, so we want to show you the standings and records of this week. Of course, it's not the midseason mark in the fantasy season. Yep. It's close enough.
But we figured we would show you who's at the top, who's at the bottom, and what everyone's record is as of right now. Because we haven't really showed the records. We've only been showing who's in first and, you know.
Yeah, and of course, actually, as well as these, we'll show also our standings and power rankings right here. They're pretty similar to obvious. Standings are obviously what we just showed you, and power rankings are what we think the teams are looking heading into the next week. Yeah, exactly. You know, obviously Sophia's team looks great, but Jake's team without Derrick Henry, he's gonna be moving down in the power rankings. So
I'm moving down as well, but it's okay.
Maybe because you lost the last place. Yeah,
I know.
All right, now we'll jump right into trades. These are some pretty exciting ones.
Yeah, a couple big ones.
Considering, you know, trades have been pretty quiet a little bit
the last couple weeks. It's not been too many.
Yeah, we'll. While we're going over some of these trades, I'll display the ones that we're not gonna talk about right here. They're still pretty good. It's just that we couldn't fit a lot of them due to time constraints. So now we'll get started on the first one. The first one, Jake sends DeAndre Swift, Kenny Galladay, Stafford, McLaurin, and Cooks to Sean for Mahomes, Jefferson, Barkley, Darrell Williams, and Dawson Knox.
Wow.
Great trade.
Yeah.
For
pretty interesting.
Probably for decent for both of them.
Yeah.
Saquon's an investment, but there's a lot of stars going on, so I think it's a good trade.
Yeah. Next, we have a trade between me and Alex. He's sending me James Robinson and James Conner, who I shipped to him after he had his big game last week. So I'm getting him back in exchange for Dalvin Cook with his ongoing investigation, as well as Miles Gaskin.
And Renfro as
and
a
Renfro.
Bonus.
Yeah.
And then finally, me and Johnny did a trade together. I'm sending DeAndre Hopkins, Daryl Henderson, Julio Jones, and Cole Beasley to Johnny Four. Yeah.
And I'm sending him Jamar Chase, James Robinson, and who else? Who's that last
Hilton.
Player? T.Y. Hilton, just to get him out of there. Because I didn't really like
a couple players were just to get out. Yeah. But I got my James Robinson back, the guy that I drafted. I traded him away twice, and now I get him back.
Yeah. And now I am remaking my dominant duo from last year of Kyler Murray and D-Hop.
Exactly. And now we'll jump right into our close games in Week 9. Yeah. Johnny,
close
you should
game.
Know about this one.
My closest game of this week was between me and Mace. 5.79 margin of victory for Mason. I benched James Conner, which really killed me. The one time I benched him all season, and it really hurt me, unfortunately.
It was unfortunate, and he was last place, which is what we talked about in the power rankings.
So now I'm falling down in power rankings.
Yeah. The biggest blowout, though, was a pretty big one. Craven versus Jake. 64.7 margin.
I know.
All because Jake's entire stars, other than Henry. Henry was out, but Jake's stars completely out on bye. Yeah. Swift, DK, McLaurin. Obviously, he traded two of them, but they were out at that point.
Yeah.
So it's a pretty big margin. Hopefully, he looks to recover. He's also falling down in the power rankings, unfortunately, because of the state of his team. But Craven's looking good sitting at two.
No, he is.
Only with two losses. One of them.
He's kind of like
being me.
Going under the radar.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Flying under the radar. He has Jonathan Taylor, so he's probably the best back in the in fantasy right now.
Yeah.
Now we'll be talking about our attaboy for this week. Johnny would know a lot about him as well because he was the highest scorer in fantasy for position players.
Yeah, I know. That is going to James Conner, who sat on my bench
for
the first time all season. He sat on my bench, and of course, you know, he's got a ball out with three touchdowns. So he is our attaboy for this week. He earned it.
He
really did.
96 rushing yards on 21 attempts and 77 receiving yards on five receptions.
That's really huge.
That's receiver numbers.
I know.
I mean, he had that one big play where he ran all the way for a touchdown off a reception. Mm-hmm. But obviously, that's
looked really solid.
Just about over 170
Yeah, roughly
something total yards, three total touchdowns, five receptions. If you're half PPR, regular PPR, I mean, insane for us. 37.8 points for. Yeah. Half PPR, obviously, that's 2.5 more, so probably like 39,
roughly
40.3.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot of points, obviously.
Now heading into our to start or to bench. To start, I'm going to go with Jerry Jeudy against Philadelphia. Obviously, he is taking that number one receiver role away from Cortland Sutton, so he's going to get the start. I'm also starting Dalvin Cook against the Chargers, who are letting up the most points in rushing against running backs.
Yeah, for me, I'm going to give the start to another Bronco, Javonte Williams versus Philadelphia. I know they have a good rushing defense, but Javonte Williams is a power rusher, and he looks angry.
He'll learn
some reps as a rookie. Also, Michael Pittman, he's emerging as a wide receiver one in that team. Carson Wentz obviously likes him, and Jacksonville's defense is struggling. Simple as that.
Yeah. And to sit, I'm going with Cortland Sutton. He put up 2 points last week, and that's only because he had the two-point conversion. Hasn't looked that good since Jerry Jeudy got back, and I would not play him probably the rest of the season.
Maybe.
Another player, I have Jared Cook going up against Minnesota and Eric Kendricks as a linebacker. I just don't like that matchup there, so I would go with the bench for him.
Following the tight end trend against a good linebacker, Fred Warner is obviously really great, and Tyler Higbee has to match up against him.
Yeah.
And that's not even the biggest issue. It's Odell Beckham coming to the Rams, so that's another weapon for Matthew Stafford to feed, and less for Tyler Higbee, who doesn't even get that many receptions and targets anyways. Then I'm going to go with a surprise one. It's in compliance with Javonte Williams' start. I'm going to bench Melvin Gordon versus Philadelphia. Obviously a good run defense. I mentioned that before. And I think Melvin Gordon's going to lose reps because Javonte Williams looks really great. And you might as well go with the young, hot hand.
Yeah, I agree.
And then finally, we're going to be jumping right into our waiver wire pickups. Johnny, your first one.
The first one I have, Jordan Howard, has put up over 10 points the last 2 weeks since he's been activated for his first game. He looks really solid, so I would definitely try and pick him up if he's still available.
Yeah, and I mean, he's been getting more reps than all the other running backs in that backfield. Has. And he's been scoring. Next up is Cam Newton. Obviously not a plug-and-play for this week. He's not going to start.
No.
But he's back. He's back in the Panthers.
He's home.
And he has a great offense to work with compared to when he left. And he's healthy. So, you know, that's just someone to stick on your bench just in case. Yeah, and then finally, we're wrapping up with Brandon Bolden. We're picking him up. He looks great last week against Carolina.
He looked really
against
solid.
Against a pretty good defense, honestly.
Yeah, that's true.
And now he's matching up against the Cleveland Browns defense, which is obviously tough, but he's going to be the starter against
So he's just going to get a ton of reps.
Yeah, because
there's no one else in the backfield.
Damian Harris and Ramondre Stevenson are both in concussion protocol. Yeah, so unless they clear it on Saturday, which we're filming on Friday.
Yeah.
I would give him the immediate start after picking him up. But
exactly.
If not, he's still good to hang on to because he's been looking really great.
Yeah. And moving into our rivalry games of the week, don't forget to get your popcorn ready.
Yep.
Number one, who do we have?
Well, I'm used to being number one, I guess, in this stuff. Luckily, last week, an update, I pulled the win off against Jenny. So now
your record is getting better.
My record, I'm 2-1 in the division.
Yeah.
Being in the hot seat, I'm now 2-2 as the number one matchup.
So we're putting you back.
And now I'm getting thrown back into
back
the fire.
Against
Sean.
Water cooler talk matchup of the week, Sean versus Noah. So don't forget to watch next week and we'll keep you updated.
Definitely. We might have him as a guest star on this show. We'll just have to see. But me and him are the number one matchup. Mm-hmm. You know, obviously leaders in our divisions. And then the next one up is Sophia versus Jake. Although he's been struggling, he's still fifth. He's still in the playoffs.
Looks pretty solid.
Still hanging on. Sophia's obviously first, so it looks like a good matchup.
Yeah.
And you never know what can come of it. And then finally, we have Craven versus Alex. Craven's obviously second. We have all the division leaders in these matchups. Pretty much
pretty cool.
No other explanation, I guess you could say. But Alex is also pure entertainment, so you never know what's going to go on.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
And that just about wraps up this episode. Pretty quick episode for you guys. We're going to be looking to make it quicker so you guys will be able to watch it all and not get bored easily. If you would like to, you can like. And if you're new here, subscribe and click the little alert bell. Obviously, follow the Twitters. And
right
Johnny, what about that TikTok?
We have more good content on TikTok. Water Cooler Talk 21, posting daily content, bunch of new football things, NFL head rollers, and a bunch of cool stuff. So don't forget to stay tuned to that. And that's pretty much all we have for you.
Yep.
So that's it.
See you next week.
Next week.
And good luck on your games. Peace.